Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dominic Mysterio, Rhea Ripley, Finn Balor, and Damian Priest, the Judgment Day!
Corey Graves, you have to imagine the Judgment Day are feeling pretty good about themselves already in the month of October. Finn Balor has made Edge say, I quit. And just last week on Monday Night Raw, Dominic Mysterio, the son of the legendary luchador Rey, went one-on-one with AJ Styles, and he managed to pin the phenomenal one. He called it the greatest victory of his young career.
No doubt about it, one of the more shocking victories in recent WWE history. But Dominic Mysterio alongside the Judgment Day, reminding all of Monday Night Raw that together they are a force to be reckoned with, no matter what the circumstance.
AJ Styles would get involved and carnage would ensue, but then, of course, the mastermind behind the Judgment Day, the wild card, Rhea Ripley, got involved, and there it is, Dominic Mysterio defeating AJ Styles. A stunning win.
Certainly shifts momentum in the favor of the Judgment Day as they prepare for battle a week from Saturday, Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, crown jewels. The Judgment Day will unite to battle a newly reunited OC of AJ Styles, Luke Gallows, and Carl Anderson.
And here tonight, they are basking in the glory of their movement, the Judgment Day, and their recent victories.
At the end of the day, you simply cannot argue with results.
Last week, AJ found out what mommy's known all along. And it is the same thing that I have been trying to get through to you thick-skulled dimwits. And that is that the Judgment Day, we run Monday Night Raw.
You tell them all the time.
Oh, and another thing that AJ found out for himself is that Dominic Mysterio is all man.
In perhaps one of the greatest matches of all time, AJ Styles faced off against my man Dom. And a phenomenal AJ Styles crumbled under the pressure against the legendary Dominic Mysterio.
That's right. And that brings me to my favorite time of the night, when you all rise. I said rise! 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 Oh, rise! You rise and show respect for the greatest luchador in the history of this business, Dominic Mysterio.
You know, the Judgment Day are...
Oi, let him speak!
The Judgment Day are the only ones who ever believed in me. And last week, I proved all of my haters and all of my doubters wrong when I beat AJ Styles clean in the middle of this ring. How did I do it? Everyone was asking how. It's because I'm built differently.
Yeah, you are.
You know, the more I think about it, I'm this generation's Eddie Guerrero. No. Eddie Guerrero was his generation's Dominic Mysterio. And last week, what I did to AJ Styles was just a small taste of what the Judgment Day.
Seems as though perhaps the OC have heard enough. The phenomenal AJ Styles flanked by Anderson and Gallows.
Dominic Mysterio, shut up. This is Charlotte, North Carolina, and they know good wrestling when they see it. And you are not it. You want to compare yourself to Eddie Guerrero? Your generation, you're the generation of James Ellsworth.
Yeah, Jimmy No Chin.
You see, Dominic, there's gonna come a time when you can't hide behind Judgment Day, because the OC is gonna pick them off one by one by one.
AJ, you're one to talk about hiding. You're the one that's hiding in the club right now. Yeah, that's right, the club that I started. And while I'm being honest, ever since I left the club and moved on, everyone that ever came after me is living off my legacy. Today, the Judgment Day are in town. Step up and get put down.
Finn Balor, it's time for you to stop talking. And it's time to remind Charlotte, North Carolina, why Carl Anderson is the toughest man in the building. Let's clear this ring and do this match, you and I, right now.
Oh, yes.
Here we go. Longtime allies turned bitter rivals, Carl Anderson, one-on-one with Finn Balor.
Let's go. In the Spectrum Center in Charlotte, North Carolina, old friends. They go back to 2005, Anderson and Balor.
Well, it could be argued that both men experienced the pinnacles of their respective careers together. Traveling the globe, primarily Japan, dominating everywhere they went as a cohesive unit. You heard Balor reference that he has been credited with creating what is now known as the OC. Perhaps Styles, Anderson, and Gallows took it to higher heights, but Balor's the one that started the entire club.
So they know each other so well. How is this gonna play?